Hey, what's up, everybody, and welcome back to 10WT Friday. The 10WT, the 10-Week Transformation, is a 10-week health and fitness program designed to build your best you both physically and mentally. It's centered around a proven six-step goal-setting framework that will help you optimize your habits, transform your body, and conquer the inevitable obstacles that life throws your way, all so that you can become the healthiest and the best version of yourself. You see, in order to achieve any goal and transform, you want to start with your why. Then you have to define a very specific goal. Then you have to identify your weekly behaviors that will get to your goal. Then you have to track your progress on a scoreboard, set micro habits that set you up for success every single week, and then you execute. If you do these steps, then your habits will be rock solid, your self-confidence will grow, and you'll be on the path to your best you. Every single week, we help health-conscious go-getters just like yourself optimize their potential. I'm your host, Nick Carrier, and today I am super excited to talk about the five things that you need to make sure that you get from the grocery store. The goal of the Best You podcast is to allow you to feel confident about what you need to do, why you need to do it, and how to do it in order to get closer and closer to your best you. You see, nutrition is one of those things where no matter how hard you work out, you're going to limit the improvement that you make from an energy standpoint, from a confidence standpoint, and from a biology and a body image standpoint. You're only going to make so much progress if you're not dialed in with your nutrition. So nutrition is super important. I probably don't have to convince too many of you guys of that. But what you get from the grocery store is super critical. I think the grocery store can be a super confusing place because of the marketing tactics that a lot of companies and brands use. So today I want to talk about the five most important things that you can get, that you need to get from the grocery store. But before I kind of dive into those five, I want to tell you a little bit of the why behind those five. And the ideal week of groceries is well-rounded. And what I mean by well-rounded is it's kind of four different things. One, it has high quality fiber to help maximize gut health and a whole lot of other things as well. Number two, it has high quality fat profile, meaning you have the proper ratio of omega-3 to omega-6 fats, which is one of the most important parts of any diet or any meal plan. Number three, you have to make sure you get high quality and proper quantities of protein for muscle mass and for so many different other bodily functions as well. And then lastly, you want to make sure that you get polyphenols and antioxidants to promote your immune health and fight against diseases. One of the guys that I listen to most is Dr. Mark Hyman, and he also always talks about how food is medicine. And literally, food is medicine when you are making sure that you're eating things like polyphenols and antioxidants. And I'll talk about how you can actually get those things when I dive into the five steps or the five things. And so let's go ahead and dive right into the five different things that you need to get from the grocery store. Number one is produce, and you need to spend most of your time in the grocery store getting produce. This is things like fruits, like bananas, blueberries, strawberries, raspberries, blackberries, apples, avocados, olives, lemons, limes. I would grab at least one from each category. A berry, apple and or banana, peaches or oranges, and then maybe avocados or olives. So those are three different categories, and lemons and limes too. That can be a great way to help flavor your water and clear out your system as well. If you can make sure that you get at least three or four fruits from the grocery store every single week, then that would really set you up for success. And one of the things I'll get into with vegetables as well is you can get great source of polyphenols and antioxidants from your fruits and your vegetables. The different colors represent different essentially medicinal properties that those fruits and vegetables are going to provide to you. So you need to make sure that you vary up your colors as well. Those of you guys who participated in the Looking Fly for July challenge that we did at Best You back in July, you know that we made you eat every color of the rainbow during the week, and the challenge was to do every single day. And that really allowed you to make sure you maximized the different antioxidants and polyphenols that you were bringing into your body so that you could help promote immune health and fight against diseases. Also, within produce, you need to obviously make sure you get vegetables. And again, vary up the colors. Get things like cruciferous vegetables like Brussels sprouts, broccoli, cauliflower, radishes, cabbage, kale. You want to make sure you get carrots, cucumbers, celery, zucchini, yellow squash, jalapenos. You need to make sure you get red, orange, yellow, and green bell peppers, tomatoes, onions, red onions, white onions, green onions. There's so many different things. Asparagus, beets. There's so many different vegetables that are great. But again, I'm not out asking you in every single grocery trip to get every single one of those vegetables that I just mentioned, but maybe choose anywhere from 3 to 6 of them and make those. So again, fruits and vegetables. If you want to write down these again, if you didn't already, blueberries, strawberries, raspberries, blackberries, apples, bananas, avocados, olives, lemons, and limes. Choose 3 to 5 vegetables, onions, bell peppers, Brussels sprouts, broccoli, cauliflower, carrots, cucumbers. Again, get 3 to 6 of those. And you need to make sure that you're having fruits and vegetables every single day. I would venture to say anywhere from 3 to 8 cups of vegetables a day would be good. And anywhere between 3 and 5 servings of fruit a day would be really great as well. You can also get things like pickles and sauerkraut as well. Those are great probiotics. Second thing you need to get from the grocery store is nuts and seeds. This is really important when we talk about getting healthy fats and especially omega-3 fats. Now, nuts and seeds are only going to provide you with ALA source of omega-3 fats. And talk a little bit more about EPA and DHA omega-3 fats when I get to protein. But nuts and seeds are going to be a great source of ALA omega-3 fats. Walnuts, almonds, pecans, cashews, pistachios, flax seeds, chia seeds, pumpkin seeds, hemp seeds. And whenever you do get flax seeds, either get the flax meal, or if you get flax seeds, make sure you put them in a smoothie or make sure you grind them up beforehand, because you're only going to get the full benefits of the flax seed if you're able to eat it when it's broken down. Because if you just have the seed itself, you're going to swallow the seed whole and you're not going to be able to actually get the medicinal properties inside of the seed as well. And then get things like almond butter or cashew butter. But look, when you're getting almond butter or cashew butter or even peanut butter, good, there's great peanut butters out there as well, you have to check the ingredients. Look for the almond butter, the cashew butter, the peanut butter that has the nut and then maybe another ingredient or two. Don't get Jif peanut butter. That stuff is crap. You need to make sure you get a nut butter with absolutely minimal ingredients. And then you can also get almond milk, cashew milk, oat milk, coconut milk. Thing number three you need to get from the grocery store is protein. And I've got a great list here that I would recommend that you jot down at least, again, maybe 2 to 4 of these that you get from the grocery store on a weekly basis. Pasture-raised eggs, organic pasture-raised chicken breasts, grass-fed ground beef, grass-fed steak, ground turkey, wild-caught salmon, shrimp, tilapia, tuna, bacon, so many great sources of protein. And you obviously want to get enough quantity of protein to maintain muscle mass and make sure the other bodily functions are working properly. But quality of protein is key. So many people know quantity, but they forget about quality. So quality of protein is key. Pasture-raised eggs. You want to make sure that the chickens that you're eating from are able to eat the things that they were meant to eat. You want to make sure that they can eat not just grasses, but bugs and insects and forage. And you want to make sure that they're fed those things. So pasture-raised eggs and pasture-raised chicken breasts. And then grass-fed ground beef, grass-fed steak. Really important that the red meat that you have is grass-fed as well. So many different reasons for that that I'm not going to get further into today. That's for another podcast episode. Wild-caught salmon. That is where you're going to get really great omega-3 fats, both EPA and DHA. And EPA and DHA omega-3 fats, that is literally what makes up your cell membranes. It's literally what also helps improve brain neural connections. So when you talk about things like dementia, when you talk about things like Alzheimer's, if you can make sure that you get in proper omega-3 fats on a daily and weekly basis, that is absolutely huge in helping with cellular health and long-term brain health as well. Number four to get from the grocery store, grains and legumes. Things like quinoa, things like brown rice, things like ancient grains, lentils, farro, black beans, edamame. Those are some of my favorite things that you can get. And grains and legumes are a great source of fiber. And depending on the legume, then you can, or the grain or legume, you can make sure you get a good protein source that way as well. Now, you want to make sure you get animal sources of protein to make sure you maximize the benefits that you can get from muscle mass building and muscle mass maintenance. But you can also get good benefits from plant sources of protein as well. Again, quinoa, brown rice, lentils, farro, black beans, edamame, great stuff. And then lastly, what you need to get from the grocery store is condiments, oils, and spices. I'll start with condiments. Condiments, something like pasture-raised butter, something like feta cheese, something like goat cheese. Like, those are some of my favorites. Hummus. Make sure you get a good source of hummus without a bunch of preservatives in there. Salsa is great to put on a lot of different foods. And I always get a lot of different condiments and salad dressings from Primal Kitchen. So you guys need to make sure you check out Primal Kitchen if you haven't done that as well. Spices. So many different spices have a lot of medicinal properties, and you want to make sure you cook with spices to make sure that you don't produce glycation end products. Advanced glycation end products are something that if you create those via the way that you cook, then they have cancerous properties in them. And so you want to make sure you cook with a lot of spices. You can do cayenne pepper, garlic powder, onion powder, Himalayan pink salt, black pepper, so many great things. And then lastly, oils. You want to make sure that you select the right oil based off of what you're using it for. Avocado oil is the most, it can be used for anything because it has a high, really high smoking point of 500 degrees. And so you can use avocado oil on things that you put in the oven at high temperatures. Extra virgin olive oil is great for salad dressings and cooking things at low temperatures. Coconut oil is also very great. And it's good at medium temperatures. And then I always get raw, unfiltered apple cider vinegar. I usually cook my meat in that. And again, that's really important with helping prevent producing advanced glycation end products, balsamic vinegar, so many different things that you can get from the grocery store, from condiments, oils, and spices because of the great benefits that they're going to provide you. So I know that was rapid fire and a lot of information, but I would encourage you to write that stuff down if you didn't. The first time I was going through it, rewind it, ask yourself where you struggle, go to the grocery store and get those things. You don't need to get anything in a box. Don't get boxed crap. It's not good. Minimal ingredients. When you go to the grocery store and you look at an ingredients label, it's like playing golf. The lowest number wins. A blueberry is a blueberry. A Brussels sprout's a Brussels sprout. Brown rice is brown rice if you get the right brand. Minimal ingredients. Number one, produce, nuts and seeds, protein, grains and legumes, condiments, oils, and spices. Build out your grocery list using those five categories. I hope you guys got something from today. I hope this helps you and provides you with guidance and practical knowledge going to the grocery store. Not just what, but why you should be getting these particular foods. Now go out and do it. Build your grocery list. Go next time you make your grocery list, go back and listen to this episode and write these five categories down and write in two to eight, depending on what category, two to eight different things from each section. That'll ensure you set yourself up for success. And also, if you want further guidance on what you in particular should be eating and how much, then make sure you join the 10-week transformation. All you got to do is go to www.nickcarrier.com/10WT. We will optimize your habits. We will transform your bodies. We're going to identify obstacles that life is inevitably going to throw our way, and we will overcome those pains in the butt. nickcarrier.com/10WT. If you're in Nashville, we're going to have a group starting on September 12th. If you're not in Nashville, you can start whenever. www.nickcarrier.com/10WT. I hope the information that you got here today helps you get closer and closer to your health and fitness goals, and ultimately helps you get closer and closer to your best you.